Hello students, today's topic we are going to see regarding value of play and selection of play materials. It's a revision. So once again we'll see what is play. Play is a child way of living or doing the daily activity. It can satisfy the needs of the child for any concept of like physical, emotional, social and mental development or in the concept of health. This is going to help for the child to attain their maximum level of health by successfully fulfilling their physical activity, emotional, social and mental development. So over this first one, we are going to see about value of play. So if you are seeing about value of play, the play is having value in the form of physical development like anatomical and physiological function. Then intellectual development, then moral development, then over the concept of creativity, then in the concept of therapeutic we are using, then in the concept of socialization, the concept of socialization. So over this first one we are going to see about physical development. Physical development mainly which is going to help for muscular and sensory abilities. So infant sensory abilities, tactile, visual and auditory abilities, those who are very well boosted and very well exercised, which is helping or helped for the attainment of physical development. So infant uses their sensory abilities, and where the sensory abilities helps the child to have the tactile, or they start to move, visual and auditory abilities, this everything help the child to move further to attain their maximum level of physical development. Where in the concept of toddler and preschooler, if you are seeing from dependence they are moving to independence, so they want to see that to what extreme they can able to challenge or they can able to fulfill their physical activity that they will be extremely practicing over. Then moving on to the schooler age group, if you are seeing schooler age group, they can able to maximum have the all kind of activity like running, skirting, jumping, climbing. Okay, all kind of sports activity, indoor as well as outdoor, all these activity help the child to have a good concept of muscular development. The next, moving on to the intellectual development. In this concept of intellectual development, where the child learns different shapes, size, colors, numbers and names in the form of play, they can able to learn soon when compared to the other concept of learning. So where here the child learns about the different shapes and size and color and numbers and names. Then they expand their knowledge and language ability by reading or listening stories. So where more interest towards, directed towards this one. So example, by reading story books, which helps the child to improve their knowledge. Then use their intellectual ability to think, and as well as the language abilities also will improve more. So over this is very well helpful for the child. So intellectual development that the child has to be practiced. Next, moral development. Moving on to the moral development, here the child learns moral values from parents, teachers and peers. Maximum if you are seeing, the learns from the parents to particular age group. Then after that they learn from the teachers. Then after that they learn from their friend circle. And after that they learn from entire surrounding. So then they learns cultural values like honesty, integrity, then compassion during play only. So according to the rules and regulation they has to play. So be honest when you are playing according to the rules and regulations. So obeying for the rules and regulations. Then integrity and compassion, always obey the order, always follow the rules. Then there should not be any partiality. Everything has to be compensated. All are equal. So where it's a sportive manners, they used to take all their activity, whether winning or losing. So where which help for the moral value of the child. Then they learn to assume responsibility for their own action. They take responsibility for their own action, either it is success or failure. But they take the responsibility only in the sportive manner, not in the concept of entire problem. So which their moral development was very well developed. helping for variable development of moral development, overall development of moral. Next, moving on to the creativity. So over the concept of creativity, playing with clays, finger paints, paper and cardboard boxes or clays, then we can able to see making some designs or diagram, drawing. These are all going to help the child to think creatively, where the child will be indulging themselves in this activity, where nowadays this is more common in the school, where they are having a special class for the child, art and creativity, where the child will be doing the art and craft work, where which is improving their creative activity. Then moving on to the therapeutic. If you are seeing the concept of therapeutic, play can provide a release from stress and tension. Yes, of course, whenever the child is having the stress and tension, or whenever the child is playing, the child will be free from all the emotional activity. Like, they will express their feelings, they will show their angers during the play, so everything will be released. The child can express emotions and release unacceptable behavior into socially acceptable fashions. Next, moving on to the socialization. Social and emotional development, where the child learns about good social relationships, problem solving, learn to give and take, right and wrong. So over this concept, we saw about the values of play. So over the value of play, the socialization, social and emotional development will be very well developing. Then play helps for good social relationships as well as problem solving for self as well as for their peers or for their friends. Then learns to give and take and right and wrong. They can able to identify as well as can able to follow. So over this we had saw about the values. The values of play are: first one is physical development, second one is intellectual development, third one is moral development, fourth one is creativity, fifth one is therapeutic, and sixth one is socialization. Okay, next, moving on to selection of play materials. So over the selection of play materials, the play materials has to be selected according to the developmental needs of the child, according to the age group of the child, according to the safe, durable and attractiveness of the child. Then toys that cause injury should be avoided. Then toys may not be expensive but must be able to create interest in children. So over this concept, if you are taking in this concept of early late preschooler as well as beginning of schooler age group, where the child more fond of toys where which is suitable and capable for their hand holding. So instead of big or luxurious toys, the child used to select for only smaller one. Then boys likes about the automobiles, like moving vehicles, like toys, toy cars or balls, or like toy aeroplane, toy like that. Then girls' preference will be for the small Barbie dolls or puppies or clays or crayons like that. So over this, it should be attractive for the child. At the same time, it should be safe for the child, and it should create interest in the child for playing. So this is about selection of play material. Then moving on to social characteristics of play. So over this concept of social characteristics of play, if you are seeing, the first and foremost one is the child follows the first beginning as onlooker play over the social characteristics. So what the onlooker means? Onlooker means just they are like an audience, watch but make no attempt to enter into the play. Active interest in observing interactions of others but do not participate. So here the child watch how others are playing and have the interest only of observation. They are not willing to participate. And second one is solitary play. Plays alone with toys different from those used by others in the same area. Then enjoy presence of other children but do not speak to them. They play individually. They never interfere with others, or they never play cooperatively with others. Their interest is centered in their own activity. which they learned on their own. More commonly, the child used to play and talk with their own toys, and incidents are like a storytelling or like a role model playing. All this will be done by the individual without not involving the other child playing alone. This is solitary plays alone. The next one is parallel play. Parallel play. So here play independently but among other children. Play with toys similar to other children, but both play with their own toys. They never exchange or never mix together. Both sit together and they both play with their own toy with their own manner, but their both activity will be same. This is about parallel play. Then number fourth one is associative play. So over the concept of associative play, if you are seeing, plays together and engage in similar activity. Plays together and engage in similar activity, but no organization or division of labor, or there is no goal. Act according to their wish. So here associative play will be present where the children all together, they used to play together, but any problem or any issue comes, they never follow the rules and regulation. Here they see that according to their act of wish, the game has to be completed. If they want, they can terminate the game at any moment, and they can shift to other game. Like usually the peer groups will be present where the child concept was not accepted by others, they used to detach from the group and they will formulate their own group and play some other games. So here the associative play will be, all will be indulging in same activity, but there is no organization will be present. According to their wish, they used to play. The next one is cooperative play. Over the concept of cooperative play, if you are seeing, children play in a group. It is organized with certain goal. There is a leader and follower. Relationship will be maintained. So here in the play concept, where the child used to take, one child used to take a leader role and remaining child used to take a followers. Example, you can take a role model play. One child will be acting as a teacher and remaining children are acting as a student. And two children will be acting as a father and mother, and remaining kids are acting as a children. So where here they are having a cooperation, they are having a story formulation, they are having an organization or organized manner they used to do, and they are having a goal attainment. Another one concept, if you are seeing, cooperative play, like team playing, captain and followers. All the students, all the children used to follow the captain's order. Okay, so this is about play or social characteristics of play. Over the social characteristics of play, if you are seeing, first one is onlooker, just audience. Second one is solitary, alone they used to play. Third one is parallel, both together plays, but they play in their own concept. The next, associative, there is no organization and the rules and regulation will be changes according to their wish. Then fifth one is cooperative play. It's like a team sports where the child used to follow the rules and regulation, and one leader will be there and remaining members are followers, and they will maintain their relationship very well to complete their task or goal. So this is about today's topic, the play and its value. Thank you.